conducting the first large-scale genome-wide analysis of ancient human remains from the Near East. An international team led by Harvard Medical School has illuminated the genetic identities and population dynamics of the world's first farmers. The study reveals three genetically distinct farming populations living in the Near East at the dawn of agriculture, 12,000 to 8,000 years ago, two newly described groups in Iran and the Levant, and a previously reported group in Anatolia, in what is now Turkey. The findings also suggest that agriculture spread in the Near East, at least in part because existing groups invented or adopted farming technologies, rather than because one population replaced another. The team's analysis alter what is known about the genetic heritage of present-day people in Western Eurasia. They now appear to have descended from four major groups: hunter-gatherers in what is now Western Europe, hunter-gatherers in Eastern Europe, and the Russian steppe, the Iran farming group, and the Levant farming group. Even as advances in ancient DNA technology have made it possible to probe population mixing and large-scale migrations that occurred thousands of years ago, researchers have had trouble studying the genetic history of the Near East because the region's warm climate has degraded much of the DNA in unearthed bones. The team overcame the problem of poor quality DNA in part by extracting genetic material from ear bones that can yield up to 100 times more DNA than other bones in the body. The team also used a technique called in-solution hybridization to enrich for human DNA and filter out contaminant DNA from microbes. The combined techniques allowed the researchers to gather high-quality genomic information from 44 ancient Near Easterners who lived between 14,000 and 3,400 years ago, hunter-gatherers from before the invention of farming, the first farmers themselves and their successors. By comparing the genomes to one another as well as to those of nearly 240 previously studied ancient people from nearby regions and about 2,600 present-day people, the researchers learned that the first farming cultures in the Levant, Iran and Anatolia were all genetically distinct. Farmers in the Levant and Iran were genetically similar, however, to earlier hunter-gatherers who had lived in the same areas. The findings tell a different story from what researchers believe happened later in Europe, when the first farmers moved in from Anatolia and largely replaced the hunter-gatherers' populations who had been living there. Over the following 5,000 years, the Near East farming groups mixed with one another and with hunter-gatherers in Europe. The researchers also learned how descendants of each early farming group, even as they began to intermingle, contributed to the genetic ancestry of people in different parts of the world. Farmers related to the Anatolian group spread west into Europe. People related to the Levant group moved south into East Africa. People related to those in Iran or the Caucasus went north into the Russian steppe. And people related to both the farmers in Iran and the hunter-gatherers from the steppe spread into South Asia. Finally, the study provides a few more clues about the hypothetical, even more ancient population called Basal Eurasians, an early diverging branch of the family tree of humans living outside Africa, whose existence Lazardis has inferred from DNA analysis, but whose physical remains have not yet been found. To the researchers' surprise, statistical analysis suggested that the Basal Eurasians may have had no Neanderthal DNA. Other non-African groups have at least 2% Neanderthal DNA. The team believes this finding could help explain why West Eurasians have less Neanderthal DNA than East Asians, even though Neanderthals are known to have lived in West Eurasia.